What it do, gang? It's your boy Don, and we back with another video, man. Once again, we starting a video outside, man. Y'all know how it go. And like I told y'all, man, we dropping these motherfucking videos, bro. It might be more than I really expected or anticipated, based on like the rate that I'm working at and the lack of equipment and things like that. But nevertheless, man, we gonna get it done. So, like I said, with that being said, welcome back to the channel. If you're new to the channel, make sure y'all hit that red subscribe button, man. Hit that bell notification so y'all can get notifications and updates when I do upload a video, man. Make sure y'all give this video a thumbs up. If you haven't seen the last video, make sure you go watch that video as well. Also, give that video a thumbs up. And the video before that, which is the Taco Tuesday meet. Honestly, that video is not doing the numbers like how I really thought it would. I don't know if it's just the editing in that or people just didn't really like that video or whatever. I don't know, but it is what it is. But back to your regular programming, this video. Part two to the last video, I guess. So back with more of the teardown video for the GTI. But the plan for the day is my goal is going to be to get the turbo off. I really want to inspect the turbo, so that's really a goal for the day. I'm gonna take the turbo off. I really want to inspect that. What else? I might jack it up. I might jack the left side up, put that side on the one jack stand that I do have, and then I'm gonna take the driver's side wheel off because I need to take that axle out eventually. I need to take the axle out because the transmission. I'm gonna take the transmission out with the motor as well. I believe I'm gonna do that. So eventually that gotta come off. But man, enough of my face, man. Let me turn the camera around, man. Cause y'all don't wanna see me. Y'all wanna see the car. Y'all wanna see some action. So let me turn this camera around for y'all, man. All right. Okay, y'all. We got the camera turned around, back on. Man, big shout out to Summit, you know, for the fender cover. I guess, you know, you order so much off of Summit, you get a free fender cover, which is cool. They should have sent two, but yeah, big shout out to Summit. But big shout out to APR too. And actually, big shout out to New German Performance in which one did I go to? In Aberdeen, Maryland, man. When I had that major boost leak, and come to find out, it was this pipe right here, the stock pipe, because it was plastic. So they replaced it for your boy. You know, this was a while ago. It wasn't no time soon. This was sometime like last year. But big shout out to New German Performance. They put the APR pipe along with the silicone hose as well. So big shout out to them. But yeah, so like I said, the goal of the day is to get this beauty off of here. So really just disconnect obviously the downpipe. We got a couple of coolant and oil hoses. And then, you know, it's 4 bolts, so pretty simple. Pretty simple, really. So that's the goal for the day. And I might take the belt off, and I might take the alternator and the compressor off, because it all has to come off anyway, you feel me? It's all gonna have to come off regardless. And actually, I think I'm gonna take the manifold off too, because it's gonna have to come off eventually. It's gonna have to come off regardless. So I think I'd rather take it all off, you know, beforehand. And I think I confused myself last time, guys. I thought, obviously we got the, you know, engine hook right here for the hoist. And I thought it was another one, unless I'm tripping. I thought it was another one, two like diagonal from each other. So, you know, I can hoist it up. But, yeah, man, enough of me talking, man. Let's get to work. Enough of me talking. Let's get to work. Okay, guys, so music, sorry. Oh, y'all. All right, guys, so I gotta nail it down real quick just because the way I got the camera set up. But my plan of attack, really, I'm just gonna start disconnecting little sensors, little small sensors and things like that. This kind of little sensors kind of work my way back to like the turbo area, but I'm really just trying to assess everything here real quick and see how I'm gonna go. Like, I need to disconnect like little sensors like this to like the water pump housing and or like the thermostat housing and whatnot. Just so I can like kind of prep and taking a manifold off. So I think, yeah, so really, guys, my goal is turbo, take off the turbo, and then take off the manifold. Really, I think that's gonna be my plan of attack. That's gonna be my two goals today, is to take off the manifold and take off the turbo. So yeah, we getting right to that right now. Yeah. Okay, y'all, I got y'all set up pretty decently. Hopefully the camera don't fall, man. I don't know if y'all see this little white corner right there at the bottom, but I got y'all on the GTR, on the wing of the GTR. But look, man, I was doing some work off camera, doing a lot more work off camera, so I got a bunch of this harness. As you can see, I got the harness out the way right here, but I'm gonna zoom in some more for y'all in a little bit and let y'all see all that. But watch this. Alright. Manifold out, y'all. Got the manifold off. Yeah. So we got one goal for the day. I gotta crouch down all the way out here. But we got one part of our goal today. Out. Okay, gang. We back with it, man. Oh, man, we were just out here cranking. Just pause the music. We out here cranking, man. We cranking away at this as well. We'll see. From the last clip, let's see. I finally got this damn AC line off. That took me a while to get off. I tape up the portholes right here. Got some masking tape. Tape up the mask holes. And then I took the PCB off, but then quickly realized I need to put it back on because the cams is exposed right there. But right now I'm working on getting the turbo off right now. If the camera will focus. Sheesh. But yeah, I'm working on getting the turbo off right now as we speak. I'm getting the coolant and oil lines off. There's one more line at the bottom, like right under it. Right under the turbo. Just like this line right here, but it's literally directly right under. So my plan to attack that one is I'm gonna loosen the bolts. I'm probably really gonna take them all off at this point, but take the four bolts off for the turbo that hook that bolts up to the back of the block, and then that way so I can kind of tilt the turbo back and then give me more access to get that last line underneath. So that's what I'm about to do right now. Alright, gang, man. What it do, man? We are back with it, man. I got another surprise, man. Another goal reached today, man. And we got the last bolt or nut on the turbo to take it off. So let's get it, man. Let's take this turbo off and let's inspect it, because I'm dying to see what it looks like. So this is make it or break it, y'all. This is either I gotta buy a new turbo or I don't. So let's get it. Ugh. The last one, y'all. I'm digging out of apple juice. Let me see. Oh, wait, y'all. I forgot, man. I actually kind of forgot I got to get this last bolt at the bottom of the turbo. But I do got the turbo off. But let me get this line off real quick, y'all. And I'll be right back with it because I know I'm about to struggle with it. So, and I don't want to bore y'all with me struggling. So, I'll be right back with it, y'all. All right, y'all, we finally did it, man. So I ended up taking more of these solenoids off, but we got the turbo off, finally. As you can see, we got oil all over it. I actually think some oil was coming out of it, if I'm not mistaken, y'all. Let me see something. I mean, it doesn't look like there's nothing coming out now. Probably from one of the oil holes or something, maybe. It probably came from one of the oil holes or something, but let me set this joint up over here on my toolbox, y'all, and then show y'all what we'll be working with real quick. All right, y'all, we moved over here on the workbench, aka toolbox. Got the turbo right here. Actually, you know what, I'm gonna turn you guys around real quick without kind of messing this up, but all right. So we got the camera turned around here. Like I said, some oil. That Eqt, baby. Damn. Oh yeah, man, as you can see, it's oil right there. Not sure where it came from. Like I said, it probably came from one of the oil lines or something. Or me, like, turning the turbo. Because I turned the turbo, like, 360 over. And this is the one underneath that. The pain in the ass. Oh no, sorry, not that one. This one's the pain in the ass right here. This one was the pain in the ass one right there. But I think that's an oil feed line too, I believe. But nevertheless, I mean, the baby's spinning. It's spinning. You know what I'm saying? And from what I can grasp, it don't feel like there's shaft play. I guess I won't really know if it's like really blown or anything unless I guess taking it apart, but I'm not going to take it apart. I'm going to just really trust that it's good, y'all. Honestly, that side of it spins. Let's see if we got play. Nope, no play on the hot side or the cold side. Like I said, I'm not going to take it apart. The wastegate looks good. Is it me or is that boot ripped on the wastegate right here? Or is it supposed to be like that? I don't know, but yeah, that's that, y'all. I'm not gonna take it apart. There's some oil in there. I'm gonna clean that oil up. I'll get some brake clean and some compressed air and just kind of blow it out or whatever. But that's the turbo. And so let's come over here. Back to this. Like I said, I had already taped that everything up, like here. Then we got this exposed right back here. So I'm gonna have to cover that up with some tape as well. But, y'all, my progress, I got what I wanted to get done today.